Another month and another big batch of currently empties that I have saved just for y'all to share. This month, I'm actually updating you on some new products that I tried. Yeah, two new products that I, well, three. We'll get to it. The point is, there are some products that maybe I've shared like Ulta hauls or Sephora hauls or Walmart hauls. So I'm gonna start like rounding them out, like rounding out that story. So maybe it's a new product that I'm trying. And then once I finish it, I'll be sure to connect the dots for you so you can know where I tried it and what haul I tried it in. And now if I would ever purchase it again. So here you have it. It's this month's March currently empties. So this month I'm sharing 9 products with you. So first up, it's the Bye Bye Foundation Full Coverage Moisturizer by It Cosmetics. Duh. I wear the color medium tan. I go between medium tan and medium neutral, just kind of depending on if I had a spray tan or if I'm going all natural, like my natural skin color. Thing I love about this, it has SPF 50 in it. It has flex technology, which means it kind of moves as your skin moves. I love being able to find a full coverage foundation that doesn't feel like a full coverage foundation, that wears more like a moisturizer. Moisturizer covers everything and has SPF. It checks a lot of boxes for me. And it's just a product that, quite honestly, it's never broken my skin out. It's never irritated my skin. I've just had really great success with this foundation and I'm super loyal to it. So if you haven't tried it, I really do recommend. As of now, the only places you can really get it are QVC, HSN, and Ulta. I've shared some of the deals with QVC and HSN before, but I purchase it if I'm in person at Ulta. So that's that. Next up, another no shock, is the Tarte Shape Tape. I wear the color light medium. I love Tarte Shape Tape. It is full coverage and it's a lot. I mean, it requires blending. It requires the whole nine yards. It's not like a no face of makeup concealer. So don't expect to ever have it look natural, because I don't think that's really a shtick. But if you are trying to conceal, whether it's like a pimple or some really dark circles, it does the job. So, but it's not like a no makeup makeup concealer. You feel me? So I will replenish this because I do like to have it for those heavy duty days. But I do want to speak on another concealer that I finished that I don't think I'm going to purchase again. I shared this. It might have been a Sephora haul. I'll figure it out exactly and put it in the caption below. I think it was a Sephora haul. It's the Magic Away Liquid Concealer by Charlotte Tilbury. I like it. Here's what I do like. I like this sponge applicator because I could just like draw it on. It's a no makeup makeup concealer. So if you're somebody who maybe thinks this is too like chalky and dry, if you're a drier skin, you might like this. But I didn't think that this was like, oh my God, my bags are done and covered and concealed. I thought the finish of it was really pretty. I would like this in like a foundation. I just didn't think it was, the texture or the consistency was what I want in a full coverage concealer, but it's pretty. I won't buy it again. Okay, so that's that. But something else I will buy again by Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Pillow Talk Diamonds Lip Gloss. It's not a gloss because it's not like liquidy, but I would layer it on top of a lipstick. It's just really shimmery. It's got a nice consistency. So if you like the look of a gloss, but you don't like how gloss doesn't last very long, maybe try this. I've layered it on top of the just regular Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk and I love it. But I do want to let you know it doesn't last a long time. Like maybe one will last me like maybe a month, which I mean, I guess I apply lipstick a lot, but still, I feel like, don't you think it should last longer? Yeah, I think it should last longer. I've already repurchased it, but I don't know. It's kind of expensive for how much you have to reapply it. But if you like it, who cares? SkinCeuticals Epidermal Repair. I'm so passionate about this product. So if you are somebody who has had like a skin freak out and then you're going through the drying, like drying, peeling phase, or maybe you're going through like retinol scaries, this is just something that I think belongs in your arsenal of products. The interesting thing about this product is it's not about hydration. It's more about providing like a really healthy barrier so that your skin underneath can heal. So it does moisturize in the sense that like if you have the flakies, you can glop this on and you get that glow and you get that hydration, but it's not hydrating from like the inside out. It's just hydrating kind of the top layer. But the thing about it is it creates like a barrier so that like that new skin that's coming in isn't compromised and that you can kind of keep it really safe. A comparable product I would say to this, that's not a lotion form, but that's more of an ointment form, would be like the CeraVe ointment that I've talked about before. So if you've had a sunburn, if you've had a micro peel, if you've had microdermabrasion, if you've had IPL, if you've had a laser, a Fraxel, any of those type of procedures, I would really consider investing in this and keeping it while your skin repairs itself. So that's that. I love it. You can get it online. I usually get it at Blue Mercury. Next up, while we're speaking about skin, I guess this is kind of a skin thing. Eight Greens. I love Eight Greens. I talk about this product a lot, especially when I'm traveling. It's one little tablet that you drop into an 8-ounce glass of water, and then you get a full serving of greens. So you get spinach, wheatgrass, kale, blue green algae, spirulina, chlorella, barley grass, aloe vera. They just launched their Eight Greens Skin, which also includes biotin and marine collagen. So I just think these are great if you're somebody who has an active lifestyle, a busy lifestyle, you don't always get the greens in your diet. This is just a really great way to supplement it in. Also, I've really started using it in my smoothies as opposed to using like a huge chunk of spinach, because I just really think when you add spinach to a smoothie, it changes the whole flavor of it. But I know I need my greens in that capacity. So I dissolve one of these into a glass of almond milk and then pour that into my smoothie. You can also dissolve this into bone broth or into chicken broth when you're cooking, if you're trying to like sneak that into your kids' meals. The founder of this actually has a cookbook where she shares how to use these in the kitchen. So I'll also add a link to that so you can check that out. It's just a product that I've really loved, and it just gives me such peace of mind when I know maybe I'm traveling and not eating the best, then I know, whew, I can have an Eight Green and then feel better about myself. Also finished my Donna Karan Cashmere Mist deodorant. I first started wearing this deodorant back in July before we went to Italy. I've become this deodorant's like biggest fan and like publicist, basically. Like, Donna Karan, you should put me on the payroll. I don't think about my armpits ever anymore. And I've repurchased this a handful of times now. My mom wears it. My friends wear it. Love this deodorant so much. I have one here. I have one at Kyle's house. I would even say a dude could use this deodorant. It's a deodorant and antiperspirant. It's not natural. It's not organic. I don't want to talk about natural deodorant. I like this deodorant. My armpits like this deodorant. I think people around me like this deodorant because I don't smell. It's just fantastic. I just love it. And it's $28, which feels ridiculous, but it lasts, I think one probably lasts like 3 months or so. It's just, you know, like an investment, you know, in your armpits. And I feel good about that. Okay. And then last up, let's talk about some hair products. R&Co Vicious Hairspray. You know, I love this. They just started selling it in travel size, which I'm so excited about. So I picked up a handful of the travel size ones when I was at Revel Workshop, which is where I get my hair done here in Dallas. I have not purchased these online, so I'm not sure where to get them online. I will find out and link below. Obviously, my hairstylist sells this, so that's that. But I do love R&Co. I know they sell it on Nordstrom. And then what's the company of all the, not Space NK? They sell it if you have a Space NK store. Thank you, R&Co, for finally launching a travel size of the Vicious Hairspray. And last but not least, it's the Fat Boy Tousle and Go Texture Spray. Also something that I picked up at my hairstylist. I have no clue where to buy this in person. I've only ever seen it at Revel Workshop. She also sells this in a travel size, which is why, like, moving forward, I'm not liking any hair products unless they come in travel size. It toys with my emotions so badly when I fall in love with a product and then I can't take it on a trip with me. The thing I like about this, part hairspray, part texturizer, all the grit, lift, and hold needed for an undone look that lasts. That is me in a nutshell, and I love it. Oh, and it smells really good. It kind of smells like a hot guy who like maybe worked at Abercrombie when he was in high school. Anyways, if that doesn't sell you, I don't know what would. So there you have it. It is my currently March 2020 empties. Hey, what did you finish this month? I want to know about what products you emptied out in the month of March. Let me know in the comments below. Let me know if you're going to buy them again. Share the love. Let us know what we need to buy, what we need to purchase, and what we don't need to buy. We got to spread the love here in the current community. Hey, and don't forget to go to currently.com. There's more beauty, skincare, makeup, style, fashion, travel, shopping, all over there.